Hi viewers, in this session we are going to discuss infinite series. Under the topic infinite series, we are going to discuss the following. First, we define what is an infinite series with example. Sequence of partial sums of an infinite series. We will discuss the behavior of a series. Then we will discuss the properties of a series. We also discuss the convergence of the geometric series. Finally, we state and prove the necessary condition for convergence of a series. Now look at the expressions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, so on, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, so on, 1, 8, 27, 64, so on, 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, so on, 1, comma, 1 by 2, comma, 1 by 2 squared, so on, 1 by 2 power n, so on. Now look at the other type of expressions. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10, 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 25, 1 plus 8 plus 27 plus 24 so on, 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 so on, 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 squared plus so on, 1 by 2n plus so on. Now look at the two types of expressions, left hand side and right hand side expressions. What we are going to infer from this? If you look at the left hand side of these expressions, the first one can be written as sequence an whose nth term is n. The second one is sequence an whose nth term is 2n. The third expression is a sequence an whose nth term is n squared. The fourth one is the sequence whose nth term is n cubed. The fifth one is a sequence, well-known sequence, whose nth term is minus 1 power n. And the last one is the sequence an whose nth term is 1 by 2 power n. Coming to this side. What about the first one? We can simply write sigma n. Next one is summation 2n, where n is from 1 to infinity. The third one can be written as sum n squared, sum running from 1 to n, whose value we know n and n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. What about the fourth one? Sum of squares, cubes of first n terms of a natural number. Here it is infinite, but we consider here the sum of finite sum. We consider here the finite sum n cubed, the sum running from 1 to n, whose value is n and n plus 1 by 2 whole squared. What about this? The sum Sn is 1 if n is odd, 0 if n is even. What about the next one? Next one is a series 1 by 2 power n. We can find the sum. Now, what is the difference between the first set of expressions, second set of expressions? The first set is nothing but sequences. What is the second one? Series. Then what is a series? Since we are going to discuss about infinite series, first we define what is a series. A series is a sum of elements. The sum can be finite or it can be infinite. The elements of the series can be either numbers or letters or a combination of both. A series can be represented by listing a number of elements along with the appropriate sign plus or minus. between the elements. A series can also be represented by using what is called sigma notation, just now we are used in the previous slide, with only the general terms and the range of the summation is indicated. What is a finite series? A series consisting of a finite or limited number of terms is called a finite series. What is an infinite series? A series consisting of an infinite number of terms is known as infinite series. We confine our attention to only infinite series. Now we'll define what is a series. Let an be a real sequence, then the expression of the form a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus so on plus an plus so on is called an infinite series or simply series. When we say series, we mean it is an infinite series. It is denoted by the sigma sign, sigma an. N is running from 1 to infinity. We simply hereafter call it as series AN. Whenever we write the sigma notation, sigma AN, as N is from 1 to infinity, we call it as series AN. Or without the suffix N, because it is understood that it is an infinite series, so we need not mention n is from 1 to infinity. We simply write sigma an, that is the series an. The series an is a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus so on plus an plus so on. In the above, the symbol plus between the terms, plus, 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 the symbol plus is a dummy symbol, nothing to do with usual addition, which is meant for simply adding finite number of terms. The real numbers, namely a1, a2, a3, a4, so on, an, are known as the first, second, third, fourth, so on, nth terms of the series. The series AN is called the general term of the series. Sometimes it is convenient to index the terms of a series beginning with n is equal to 0. Generally it is from n equal to 1 to infinity. Sometimes we also start with n is equal to 0 instead of n equals to 1. Now we define what is partial sum. The sum of a finite number of terms of an infinite series is called partial sum. Let Sn equals to the series An, n is from 1 to n, or Ai. Let Sn be the series AI, I is running from 1 to n, that is A1 plus A2 plus so on plus AN. B, the sum of first n terms of the series AN. Then this Sn, nothing but the sum of first n terms of the given series is called partial sum of the series, because the series is infinite. Here we consider only a finite number of terms. Therefore, it is called partial. It's called partial sum of the series. Example, the series I. I is running from 1 to infinity is 1 plus 2 plus so on plus n plus so on. What is its partial sum? Its partial sum is nothing but sum of first n terms, namely Sn is equals to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on n. whose value we know that sum of first n natural number is n into n plus 1 by 2. Consider another example, the series n squared, which is nothing but 1 plus 2 squared is 4 plus 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, 5 squared is 25, so on. What is its partial sum? Sn is equals to the series n squared, where n is from 1 to n. That is 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared plus so on n squared. We know the formula. Sum of squares of first n natural numbers is n into n plus 1 to n plus 1 by 6. Now we will define an important concept, namely sequence of partial sum. Let series an be an infinite series. Let Sn be the partial sum of the given series, namely a1 plus a2 plus so on an. The term may be positive or negative, because we know that the symbol plus is a dummy symbol which is to connect the terms. Now the sequence Sn is equals to sequence a1 comma a1 plus a2, that is the first two terms of the given series, then a1 plus a2 plus a3, the first three terms of the given series, so on a1 plus a2 plus a3, so on plus an, the first n terms of the series. So the sequence consists of n terms, where what is a1? A1 is nothing but the very first term of the series. A1 plus a2 is sum of first two terms of the series, namely S2. Therefore, this can be rewritten as S1. What is S1? Sum of only one term of the given series. What is S2? S2 is the partial sum. What is partial sum? Sum of first two terms of the series. What is S3? Partial sum. What is the partial sum S3? S3 stands for the first three terms of the series. What is Sn? Sn is the first n terms of the series. Therefore, the sequence Sn is equals to sequence S1, comma S2, comma S3, comma so on Sn. Remember that each S here is a partial sum of the given infinite series. Now, this sequence Sn is called sequence of partial sums of the series An. The nth term of this sequence is given by Sn is equals to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus so on An, as we discussed in the previous line. Note, to every infinite series An, there corresponds a sequence Sn of its partial sum. Example, consider the series An whose terms are 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on plus n plus so on. What is S1 here? The first term, 1. What is S2? First, sum of first two terms of the series An. What is S3? The first three terms, namely 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on. What is Sn then? The first n terms of the series, namely 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on n. Now, what is the sequence of partial sum of the given series? That is nothing but sequence S1 comma S2 comma S3 so on n. Sn is called the sequence of partial sums of the series An. Why this sequence of partial sums is important? Because We are going to discuss the behavior of a series. The behavior of a series AN is similar to the behavior of a sequence SN, where SN is the partial sum of the series AN. See, that's why the partial sum, the sequence of the partial sums of the given series is important, because the behavior of a series always depends upon its sequence of partial sums. That is, the behavior of a series AN is similar to the behavior of a sequence SN of the partial sum of the series AN. Therefore, an infinite series AN is said to be convergent, divergent, or oscillatory according as the series SN of its partial sum of AN is convergent, divergent, or oscillatory. Therefore, if you want to check the behavior of a series, first we will find or we will write the sequence of the partial sums of the series. Then we test the behavior of the sequence of the partial sum of the series. If the sequence of the partial sum of the series is convergent, we say that the given series is convergent. If the sequence SN of the partial sum of the series is divergent, we say that the given series is divergent. Thus, a series AN converges if the sequence SN tends to a finite limit. That is, the series AN converges if the sequence SN, the limit of SN as n tends to infinity, is a finite quantity or any real number. For example, consider the series 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 squared plus so on, 1 by 2 power n plus so on. What is SN here? SN is the first n terms of the given series. That is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 squared plus so on, 1 by 2 power n minus 1. Now, this is a geometric series. Therefore, whose sum is nothing but 2 minus 1 by 2 power n. If you find the limit, because we want to find sequence SN of partial sums, this SN is only one sum. We want to find all sums, therefore find the limit of SN. Limit of SN as n tends to infinity is limit of 2 minus 1 by 2 power n minus 1 as n tends to infinity. We have to apply limit for 2, but there is no n here, therefore only 2 minus 1 by, as n tends to infinity, 2 power n minus 1 tends to infinity. That is equals to 2 minus 1 by infinity tends to 0, therefore 2 minus 0 is 2. And hence the limit of the sequence SN as n tends to infinity is 2, which is a finite quantity, which is a finite quantity. Therefore, what we can say about the given series? Since the series sequence of its partial sum is convergent, therefore, the given series is convergent. A series AN diverges implies the sequence SN of the partial sum is convergent. The sequence of partial sums is divergent. That is, the series AN diverges if the limit of SN as n tends to infinity is either infinity or minus infinity. Example, consider the series N n running from 1 to infinity equals to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on n. Now what is the limit? When you take the limit of Sn as n tends to infinity, it is nothing but limit of n tends to infinity, that is equals to infinity. Therefore, the sequence of partial sum of the given series is divergent, and hence the series is divergent. A series An oscillates if the sequence Sn of partial sum of the given series is oscillatory. Yes, we know that there are two types of oscillatory. One is oscillates finitely, another one is oscillates infinitely. Now we'll discuss one by one. A series An oscillates finitely if the sequence Sn of its partial sums oscillates finitely. That is, the series An oscillates finitely if the sequence Sn is bounded and neither converges nor diverges. Similarly, a series An oscillates infinitely if the sequence Sn of its partial sums oscillates infinitely. Thus, the series An oscillates infinitely if the sequence Sn is unbounded and neither converges nor diverges. Now we will discuss examples for oscillates finitely series and oscillates infinitely series. Consider the series un whose nth term is minus 1 power n plus 1. Now what is Sn? Keep n is equals to 1. N equal to 1 means minus 1 power 1 minus 1. Therefore, minus 1 power 0, minus 1 power 0 is 1. Put n equal to 2, minus 1 whole set, minus 1 power 2 plus 1. When you say 2 plus 1, it is 3. So, minus 1 power 3 is minus 1. Similarly, when n equal to 3, we get 1. N equal to 4, we get minus 1. So, on this Sn is the first n terms of the given series, namely 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1, 2 n terms. What is n? If n is even, we get one value. If n is odd, we get one value. Now look at this. Sn is equal to 1 if n is odd. Look at first term, odd. Take sum of first three terms, 1 minus 1 plus 1. 1, 1 get cancelled, so 1. Take first 5 terms, it will be 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1. Therefore, the sum is 1. Suppose n is even, consider n equal to 2. So, 1 plus 1, the first 2 term, 1 minus 1 is 0. N equal to 4, sum of first 4 terms, 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 is 0. Thus, the sum is 1 if n is odd. The sum is 0 if n is even. Therefore, the sequence Sn oscillates finitely between 0 and 1. And hence, the series Un oscillates finitely between 0 and 1. Now consider another example, the series Un whose nth term is minus 1 to the power n plus 1 into n. Therefore, what is Sn? The first n terms of the given series, namely 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4, so on to n term. Again, What is n? If n is r, we get one value. If n is even, we get another value. Therefore, take n equal to 3. When you say n equal to 3, S3. Xn becomes S3. And that means we have to take first three terms. Namely, 1 minus 2 plus 3. What is the sum? 1 plus 3 is 4. 4 minus 2 is 2. This 2 can be written as 3 plus 1 by 2. Take n equal to 5. That means we have to take the first 5 terms of the given series. Therefore, when you say n equals to 5, S5. S5 becomes 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5. What is their sum? What is their sum? Minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6. 5 plus 3, 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 minus 6 is 3. The 3 can be written as 5 plus 1 by 2. Now look at this. What is n? N is 3. Therefore, we can replace this 3 by n. Similarly here, what is n? N is 5. Replace 5 by n. Therefore, the sum will be n plus 1 by 2. N plus 1 by 2 if n is odd. If n is even, what happened? Let us consider. Let us take n equals to 2. When you say n equal to 2, we have S2. What is S2? S2 is the first two terms of Sn. That is 1 minus 2. What is 1 minus 2? Minus 1. The minus 1 can be written as 2 by 2. Take n equal to 4. N equal to 4 is nothing but the first four terms of the given series are the first four terms in Sn. What is that? 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4. So, 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4, what is its sum? 3 plus 1 is 4. Minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6. So, 4 minus 6 is minus 2. Minus 2 can be written as minus 4 by 2. Minus 4 by 2. Therefore, here, n equal to 2. And hence, we can write n by 2. Here, n equal to 4. Hence, we can write minus n by 2. And hence, if n is even, what happened? It becomes minus n by 2. Thus, the sum will be n plus 1 by 2 if n is odd. Minus n by 2 if n is even. If we take the limit, what happened? It's not a finite limit. Therefore, here this Sn oscillates. See, values are different. Different. We get 2, 3. Here we get minus 1, minus 2. So on, it oscillates infinitely. That is the sequence Sn of its finite partial sum of the given series oscillates infinitely, and hence the series Un also oscillates infinitely. Now, what are the properties of series? This is more or less, the first property is more or less same as the properties of a sequence. That is, replacing or adding or deleting a finite number of terms in a given series has no effect on the convergence of the given series. When you say convergence of the given series, it does not mean that convergence. When you say convergence of a series or convergence of a sequence, it means the behavior. It means the behavior. So, when you say convergence of the given series or convergence of the given sequence, The series may converge or diverge or oscillate. Therefore, the important points hereafter we are going to use. Very often we use convergence of the series. When we say convergence of the series, it means the behavior of a series. That is, we have to check whether the given series is convergent or divergent or oscillates. The second property is the convergence of a series remain unchanged if each of its term is multiplied by a constant k, where k is non-zero. The third property is the series CAN converges to A and the series BN converges to B, and if P and Q are any two finite constants, then the series P into AN plus Q into BN converges to PA plus Q into B. A constant series diverges. The series K, where K is, n is running from 1 to infinity. That is, we have to write K how many times? Infinitely many times. And this series diverges. Here, AN is K. If, what is SN? SN is nothing but partial sum of the given series. That is the first n terms of the given series, namely k plus k plus k plus k n term, that is n into k. To test the convergence, we have to take the limit. Whenever you want to test the convergence of the given series, normally we take the limit of the partial sum. If you take the limit of the partial sum Sn as n tends infinity, what happened here? Limit n tends infinity, nk as n tends infinity, nk tends to infinity. That is, Sn tends to infinity as n tends to infinity. Therefore, the series, namely the constant series, diverges. But the important result here is, a constant sequence converges, whereas a constant series diverges. Now, we recall some of the results we have learned in the previous classes. A series of the form A plus AR plus AR squared plus AR cubed plus so on AR power n minus 1 plus so on is a geometric series where A is the first term and R, generally R is nth term by n minus 1th term, or you can take simply second term by first term is a common ratio. The partial sum of n terms of a geometric series is given by the series AI, I is running from 1 to n, A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus O1 plus AN, that is equals to, remember that A1 is the first term and let us assume that R is the common ratio. Therefore, the formula is the first term, namely A1 common ratio R to the power N minus 1 by R minus 1 if the common ratio is more than 1. R, the first term A1 into 1 minus R to the power N divided by 1 minus R, where R is less than 1. The second result is limit of X to the power N as N tends to infinity is 0 if X is less than 1. Remember that here x is a real number. So, limit of x to the power n as n tends to infinity is 0 if x is less than 1. its value is infinity if x is greater than 1. Its value is 1 if x is equals to 1. Suppose x is 0.25, which is less than 1, then the value will be 0. If the x value is say 2, then limit of 2 to the power n as n tends to infinity will be infinity because 2 is greater than 1. Then limit of 1 to the power n as n tends to infinity is 1. And remember that 1 power infinity is not defined. 1 to the power infinity is indeterminate form. Whereas limit of 1 to the power n as n tends to infinity is 1. Now, the same thing we will discuss using number line. This is a real number line. Let us take this is 1. According to this result, x to the power n tends to 1 as n tends to infinity when you take x is equals to 1. Now consider the values which are less than 1. All these region, all these places, that is the shaded region, is x is less than 1. Remember that 1 is not included. When x is less than 1, what is the value? The limit of x to the power as n tends to infinity value will be 0. Will be 0. What is the other part of it? That is value which are more than 1. For example, 1.000001, 1.000000025. All these values will be this side, which are greater than 1. What about this region? If we take in this region as the limit, the value of x is more than 1. Therefore, its value will be infinity. And hence, this gives a diagrammatic representation of this limit. Now, we are going to discuss the convergence of geometric series, namely 1 plus x squared plus x cubed plus so on plus x to the power n minus 1 plus so on. Let Sn, what is Sn? We know that Sn is the partial sum of the given series and Sn is the first n terms of the given series. That is 1 plus x squared plus so on x to the power n minus 1. So what is its sum? The sum is, remember that here 1 is the first term. 1 is the first term. And x is the common ratio. Because what's the common ratio? Second term divided by first term. Second term is x. By 1 is x. Therefore, x is the common ratio. The sum will be 1 minus x to the power n divided by 1 minus x if x is less than 1. Or x to the power n minus 1 by x minus 1 if x is more than 1. But remember that x cannot be equals to 1. We have few cases here. The first case is when mod x is less than 1. What do you say mod x is less than 1? When you remove the modulus, its value will be minus 1 less than x less than minus less than plus 1. So what is the sum? Sn. Sn will be 1 plus x squared so on xn power n minus 1. Since x is less than 1, mod x is less than 1, we have to take this sum, that is 1 minus x to the power n by 1 minus x. That is equals to, we divide into two parts, 1 by 1 minus x minus x to the power n by 1 minus x. How do you find the sum? For this, we have to take limit as n tends to infinity. So, take limit as n tends to infinity of Sn, that is equal to limit of 1 by 1 minus x minus x to the power n by 1 minus x. Apply limit to each and every term, then limit of the first term minus limit of the second term. Remember that here there is no x, n. In the first term, there is no n. And hence, if you apply the limit as n tends to infinity, we get the same thing. 1 by 1 minus x minus. When it comes to the second term, we are going to apply n tends to infinity. There is an n here. There is an n here. X to the power n. So, what is limit of x to the power n as n tends to infinity? It depends upon the value of x. What is x value? Less than 1. Less than 1. Whenever the x value is less than 1, limit of x to the power n divided by n minus 1 will be 0. Therefore, here when you apply the limit, what happened? We get 0 by 1 minus x. 0 by 1 minus x. 0 by 1 minus x is 0. And hence it is 1 by 1 minus x. What is x? X is a real number. Therefore, the limit of Sn as n tends to infinity is a finite quantity, namely 1 by 1 minus x. Therefore, what happened? The sequence of the partial sums of the given series is convergent. The nature of the series always depends upon the sequence of its partial sum. Since the sequence of partial sums of the given series is convergent, therefore the given series is convergent when mod x is less than 1. When mod x is less than 1. Therefore, the series is convergent if mod x is less than 1. Now, let us consider another case when x is greater than or equals to 1. We take two cases here because we know limit of x power n as n tends to infinity is 1 when x is equal to 1. Therefore, we are going to take two cases here. X is equal to 1 and the x is greater than 1. Now, sub case 1. What is that? If x is 1. If x is 1. Then what happens? Sn becomes 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to n term, that is equals to n. That is equals to n. What is the limit of Sn now? The limit of Sn as n tends to infinity is infinity because it is n here. As n tends to infinity, sum Sn also tends to infinity. Therefore, the series is divergent and diverges to plus infinity if x is equals to 1. Now, we consider the case x is greater than 1. Because we have the value of the limit of x power n as n tends to infinity when x is greater than 1. So, the next case is x is greater than 1. Then what is Sn here? Sn is whenever the sum is greater than 1, the common ratio is more than 1. We already defined here. The sum Sn will be x power n minus 1 by x minus 1 when x is more than 1. Since x is more than 1 here, Sn is x power n minus 1 by s minus 1. What about the nature of Sn, the sequence Sn? To get the nature, we have to find the limit. So, taking limit on both sides of Sn, when you take limit as of limit of Sn as n tends to infinity, limit of x power n minus 1 by x minus 1, n tends to infinity. What is x? X is greater than 1. Since x is greater than 1, limit of x power n as n tends to infinity is infinity. Therefore, this becomes infinity minus 1 divided by x minus 1. We know infinity minus 1 is infinity. Infinity by a finite quantity is infinity. Therefore, it is infinity. That is, the sequence Sn of the partial sum of the given series is divergent and diverges to plus infinity. Since the behavior of a series always depends upon its partial sum, the sequence of its partial sum. Since the sequence Sn of its partial sum is divergent, the given series is divergent and diverges to plus infinity whenever x is greater than 1. And hence, either x is equals to 1 or x is greater than 1. In both cases, what happened? The series is divergent and diverges to plus infinity. Now, case number 3, when x is equal to minus 1. We know the sum, first n terms of the series is 1 plus x squared plus x cubed plus so on, x power n minus 1. When x is equal to 1, what happened? It becomes 1 plus minus 1 plus minus 1 whole squared plus minus 1 whole cubed so on. That is, the series becomes 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus so on. That is, the sum becomes 1 when n is odd. The sum is 0 when n is even. This is the one we have already discussed. Therefore, the series oscillates finitely between 0 and 1. Therefore, whenever x is equal to minus 1, the given series oscillates finitely between 0 and 1. The next case is, when x is less than minus 1, what happened? When x is less than minus 1, multiply both sides by minus 1. Since minus 1 is a negative number, when you multiply an inequality with a negative number, the inequality will be reversed. Therefore, minus x is greater than 1. Now, let us take x is equal to minus a. When you take x is equal to minus a, what happened? We will see here. We know minus x is greater than 1. But what is x? X is equals to minus a. So now replace x by minus a. Therefore, minus of minus a is greater than 1. What is minus of minus a? Plus a. So a is greater than 1. Remember that x is less than minus 1. But what is a? What is a? A is greater than 1. So in this case, x is less than minus 1, we are taking x is equals to minus a, so that a is greater than 1. And hence, what is Sn? Sn is 1 minus x power n by 1 minus x, because x is less than minus 1 and minus 1 is less than 1. So x is less than 1. Since x is less than 1, we have this sum. That is equals to 1 minus, what is x? Minus a. So, minus a power n divided by 1 minus of minus a. Now, we have to consider two cases. Because n is here. If n is even, we have one value. If n is odd, we have another value. So, consider n is even. Then what happened? When n is even, minus a whole power n, that is minus a whole power even is minus a power, for example, minus a power 10. What is minus a power 10? A power 10. Minus a power 2. 2 is even. What is that? A power 2. Therefore, since n is even, what happened? This minus sign will go off, will be removed. It will be eliminated. Thus, when n is even, what happened? N is even, we have, it becomes 1 minus a power n. 1 minus a power a n by 1 plus a. Now we have to check its convergence. Now take the limit on both sides. Limit of Sn as n tends to infinity is equal to limit of 1 minus a to the power n by 1 plus a. What is a? What is a? A is greater than 1. If it is greater than 1, what's the limit? Infinity. Therefore, as limit of a n, limit of a to the power n as n tends to infinity is infinity because a is greater than 1. Therefore, it is 1 minus infinity by 1 plus a. 1 minus infinity is minus infinity. So, minus infinity by 1 plus a. 1 plus a is a finite quantity, and hence minus infinity by a finite quantity is minus infinity. Therefore, it tends to minus infinity as n tends to infinity. Thus, if n is even, the sequence of partial sum of the given series is divergent and diverges to minus infinity. If n is odd. If n is odd, what happens? When n is odd, Sn becomes this minus. See, minus a power odd number is minus a. Because minus a power 3. Minus a to the power 3 is minus a power 3. Minus a power 7 is minus a power 7. Therefore, minus a will remain here. And hence, what happens? Becomes minus of a to the power n. Minus of a to the power n. See, minus a power 3 is minus a power 3. Minus a power 9 is minus a to the power 9. And hence what happened? This minus and one more minus we have. It becomes minus into minus becomes plus. Thus n is odd. Sn becomes 1 plus a to the power n by 1 plus a. How to find the nature? The behavior? Take limit on both sides. When you take limit on both sides, limit of Sn as n tends to infinity is equal to limit of 1 plus a to the power n by 1 plus a as n tends to infinity. What is a? A is greater than 1. When the real number is greater than 1, what's the limit? Infinity. Therefore, limit of a to the power n as n tends to infinity is infinity. Is infinity. Therefore, we have 1 plus the limit of a n as n tends to infinity is infinity divided by 1 plus a. Therefore, it is 1 plus infinity by 1 plus a. We know 1 plus infinity is infinity. Also, 1 plus a is a finite quantity. Infinity by a finite quantity is infinity. Thus, the sequence Sn of the partial sum is divergent and diverges to plus infinity. Therefore, the series oscillates infinitely because when n is even, we have a minus infinity. When n is odd, we have a plus infinity. Therefore, what happened? It oscillates. There's no fixed value here. There's no fixed value. Therefore, it oscillates between minus infinity and plus infinity. If you consider as a single, that is Sn, it is infinite, minus infinity, that is diverges to minus infinity. But what about n is odd? It diverges to plus infinity, but it neither diverges to plus infinity nor diverges to minus infinity. It diverges to minus infinity when n is even, diverges to plus infinity when it's odd. Therefore, when x is less than minus 1, the series oscillates infinitely between minus infinity and plus infinity. Thus, the series 1 plus x prime plus x power 3 so on plus x power n minus 1 plus so on converges if modulus of x is less than 1. When you remove the modulus, what happens? It becomes minus 1 less than x less than 1. That is, the value of x is lie between, the value of x lie between minus 1 and plus 1, the series converges. Remember that here, neither minus 1 nor plus 1 included. Neither plus 1 nor minus 1 is included in this. We have strictly less than symbol. Therefore, the series is convergent whenever the value of x lie between minus 1 and plus 1. Diverges if x is greater than or equals to 1. We know in number line, the right side is more than 1. Therefore, when you say this x is greater than or equals to 1, this is a region. Remember that here 1 is included. 1 is included in the region. Therefore, this is a region in which x takes the value equal to 1 or greater than 1. In this case, what happened? The series diverges. Oscillate finitely if x is equal to minus 1. At the value of x is equal to minus 1, a particular value, x is equal to minus 1, what happened? The series oscillates finitely between minus 1 and plus 1. Also, it oscillates infinitely if x is less than minus 1. The left hand side of minus 1 will be less than minus 1. Therefore, this is a region, x is less than minus 1. Remember that minus 1 is not included here. In this region, 1 is included. In this region, minus 1 is not included. Therefore, in this region, what happened? X value will be less than minus 1. In that case, the series oscillates infinitely. So, this is a diagrammatic representation of discussion of or the convergence of the geometric series 1 plus x plus x squared plus x cubed so on.